In this video, you're going to see me make a 4-ton glue pulling monster out of a load of steel. Hey, I'm back for part 2 of a glue pull tower build, and so are you. Right then, for those that didn't see part 1, basically I started off the build by cutting the base and the uprights, welding them together, cut the swinging arm and dry fitted the hydraulic ramp. In part 2, you're going to see me finish it off, paint it, do a few modifications and show you what it's all about. So grab a brew and enjoy.
Right then, let's get cracking with this project and start building the adjustable pulling hoop. And what I have here is a length of 50 by 50 box section, chain and a couple of carabiners and screw locks. For the hoop, I'm using a simple DIY gate lock hoop. You can buy one of these from any local hardware store. And I'm cutting a section of the box at 80mm. The hoop is zinc coated, so I need to get rid of this coating before I can weld it to the box section. To lock the hoop in place on the pulling arm, I need to countersink holes every 100mm. And to lock it in place, I'm using the 13mm nut and bolt, reshaping the end so it will fit in the countersunk holes nice and secure, and then welding it onto the 50 by 50 box.
Now that I've finished building the pulling tower, I need to make sure it won't cockle over when we're using it. So at the moment it is quite unstable. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get some more box section. I've got some 30mm and some 40mm box. I'm going to pop the 30mm through the centre, like that. I need a metre's worth, so I'm just going to chop this bit off there and then measure 500, chop it in the middle so both ends can come out separately. And then, for the supporting bit, going to pop it on like that and weld it to the 30mm. So I'm just going to measure this, maybe give it like half a metre or something like that, 500mm, and then same on the other side. So I'm going to chop it, weld it up, and also just going to pop a hole in there so I can secure it as well, so it won't push back in under pressure. Right then, let's get on with it.
Because I've made these feet totally retractable and need to be able to lock them in place. So to do this, I'm drilling two holes 100mm apart and then drilling locking holes into the feet every 100mm. For the locking pins, I'm using a 10mm nut and bolt and welding the nut to the base, and then with the 10mm bolts I can screw them down into the feet and this will hold them and stop them from moving.
There is one more thing. Because it's made from steel, quite a lot of steel, it is really heavy. So I've been racking my brains and I've come up with a really good idea. put some wheels on it.
After the first trial using it on a job, the glue pull tower was moving around a little bit, so it's obvious that it needed anchoring to the floor. So using some C-channel slotted bar, I then drilled it into the floor, and cutting off a section, I fitted it to the removable feet, made an L-shaped bracket. This fits nice and snugly into the channel, and this glue pull tower is not going anywhere. Also, I've run the channel for about 10 foot, so I can easily reach any panel on the side of a vehicle, whether it's a car or a van. Here is the finished pulling tower, and I decided to paint it with an artistic twist using gloss black and vibrant green. After initial testing, I decided to permanently fix the hydraulic ram in place using a 17mm nut and bolt through a hydraulic ram, and for the rear mounting pin using some 12mm bar. I also welded in some 5mm bar around the fulcrum point to take up some of the slack on the pulling arm. And finally, the last modification that I made was to put in place a maximum travel stopper pin. This is to stop the pulling arm from overextending if the glue lets go early. With a quick twist from the relief valve, the ram retracts nice, steady, and under control. So how much throw does this pulling arm actually have? So if I pump it up to its maximum on the hydraulic ram, you can get a tape measure and I'll show you. From the top of the uprights to the pulling arm, there's about 400mm of travel. And then from the very top of the pulling arm to the centre of the uprights, about 600mm, and this is more than enough for any glue pull repair. And finally, the adjustable pulling hoop, carabiners and chain setup. I made it nice and simple to adjust this pulling hoop, just a few turns from the 13mm bolt on the back, and I can adjust it at every 100mm increments on the pulling arm.
That's it, that is the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it because I certainly did. I loved building this glue pull tower, something different, and also getting to show you how I did it at the same time, amazing. After the first trial, there was a few areas that needed modifying. Mainly it needed anchoring to the floor and the pivot points were a bit wobbly, so I just tightened those up and I was absolutely bomb-proof. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, it'd be great to get a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, make sure you do because it helps my channel grow. And also tick that notification bell and you'll be notified as soon as I bring out another video like this. Well, maybe not like this, but definitely a dent repair. So yeah, that's it for me now. Thank you very much. Take care and see you soon.